Hey guys, in this video we are going to generate multiple Word documents based on an Excel list. So I've got here a Word document with different placeholders. Python should iterate over each row and substitute the placeholders. So let's take an example. For the first document, Python should replace client with Mr. Jason Peterson, the vendor should be replaced by Hall PLC, and so on. We want to do this for all the rows in this sheet. So the final output will look like this. We have a dedicated folder that holds all our different Word documents based on the Excel list. One of my YouTube subscribers came up with this automation idea, and I think this can be a real time saver. If you also have any video requests, please let me know in the comments. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. First things first, we need to install the required dependencies for this project. We will need Pandas, OpenPyXL, and docs.tpl. You can install those modules by typing pip install followed by the package name. Once we've gotten that out of the way, let us get our feet wet with a simple example. In this example, we will create only a single Word document using the docs.tpl library. Once we understand how this module works, we will generate the Word documents in bulk based on our Excel list. And with that said, let me create a new Python file. As a first step, I will import the dependencies. In the Word template, I want to insert today's date and the date in 1 week. To get that information with Python, I'm going to import datetime. As we will be also dealing with different file paths, I will import path from pathlib. Both libraries are standard Python modules, so no further installation is required. Then I'm going to import docs template from docs.tpl. With that in place, I will specify the path to the Word template. The Word template is located in the same folder as my Python script. So the base directory will be the current working directory, or you could also type the parent directory of this file. With the base directory defined, I'm constructing the path to the Word document. To get today's date, I will use the datetime module. With that module, we can also calculate the day in 1 week by adding a time delta of 7 days to the present day. Next, I will initialize the docs template object with the file path we have constructed earlier. To substitute the placeholders in the Word document, we will be using a Python dictionary. Let me write down the dictionary and then I will explain this in more detail. So you might see already how this module works. The dictionary key represents the placeholder of our template. Docs.tpl will then substitute the placeholders with the respective value. For example, the placeholder client will be replaced by Sven. The non-refundable amount is 20% of the total amount. I have rounded the result by 2 decimals as we are dealing with currencies. By default, the dates we have calculated earlier will include a timestamp. However, I am only interested in the year, month, and day information. And that is the reason I have typed it like this here. Okay, and once we have our mapping table, we can render the document. As the last step, I will save the Word document in the same folder and name it Generated Contract. And that is all there is to it. Let me execute the script and go back to our folder. As we can see, Python has generated a new document for us. In this document, all the placeholders have been substituted. Now, instead of hard-coding the placeholders into the Python script, I would like to generate the Word documents based on my Excel list. So let me open up the Excel file I have prepared. The first thing I would like to highlight is the header names. Those names should match with the placeholder names in your template. For the different calculations, I have used Excel formulas. As before, the non-refundable fee will be 20% of the total amount. Additionally, I'm using the Excel formula today, and in the column next to it, I'm adding 7 days to that date. For each entry, so each row, I would like to create a separate Word document. Let us now see how to do this in Python. Therefore, I will make a new Python file. As a first step, I'm going to load our dependencies. We do not need datetime, as we have already done the date calculations in Excel. However, to retrieve the Excel data, we will be using Pandas. Under the hood, Pandas is using OpenPyXL when dealing with Excel files. And that is also why we have installed it at the beginning of the video. Next, I will set up the different file paths, so the base directory and the path to the Word template. Additionally, I will also specify the path to the Excel file. I will save the generated Word documents in a dedicated folder. I will call this folder Output. With pathlib, we could also create this folder. If the folder exists already, pathlib will raise an error which we can ignore by setting exist OK to true. With that in place, I will convert our Excel data into a Pandas data frame by typing pd.readExcel followed by the Excel file path and the sheet name. Pandas will notice that we have used dates in our Excel file and will automatically add a timestamp. But as before, I'm only interested in the date, so we can convert it by using todayTime and dt.date. I will do this for the today and today in 1 week column. And here comes the magic. As we have seen, we will need a dictionary, so a mapping table, to generate the Word documents. And with Pandas, we could easily convert the content of our data frame to dictionaries. There are different dictionary structures available within Pandas. In our case, we want to set orient to records, which will return a list of dictionaries. And now we just need to iterate over that list to generate the Word documents. So for each record, I will initialize the docs template object. Then I can render the document and create the output path. As mentioned already, I want to save it to the output directory. For the file name, I will insert the vendor of the current record by using an fstring. And as a last step, I will save the document under the output path. Okay guys, and that is all there is to it. Now, executing the script might take some time depending on how many documents you're generating. But you will find a new folder in your directory once done. In this folder, we will have all our different Word documents. And just to validate that it worked, I will open up one document and compare it with the Excel data. Okay, and this is how you can generate Word documents in bulk using Python. If you have any other automation ideas or topics you would like to see on this channel, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.